What lies behind us and what has been lying before us are actually tiny matters when we compare it to what lies actually within us. या ये कहें कि खुद ही को कर बुलंद इतना कि हर तकदीर से पहले खुदा बंदे से पूछे कि बता तेरी रजा क्या है. स्वागत करती हूँ एकता भ्यान का, भारत की इस बेटी का जो अपने आप में एक मिसाल है. प्रधानमंत्री श्री मोदी जी ने स्वयं मन की बात में एकता भ्यान का जिक्र किया. मैं सादर नमन करती हूँ एकता के माता पिता का, घर के सभी वरिष्ठ सदस्यों का जिन्होंने विषम से विषम परिस्थितियों में भी एकता को टूटने नहीं दिया और दुनिया को दिखा दिया कि परिवार अगर साथ हो और हौसला मजबूत तो दुनिया की कोई ताकत इंसान के जिंदा रहने के और कामयाब होने के जज्बे को मार नहीं सकती. वेलकम एकता टू द कम्युनिक सीरीज ऑफ माइंड एंड आई एम इलेटेड टू हैव यू एज अ गेस्ट हियर.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot for inviting me here. And I'm equally excited to have a conversation with you.
Yeah, and let me tell the audience that for the last 5 days, Ekta has not been having the internet facility in Hisar, and we were actually not sure whether we would be able to materialize this. But thankfully enough, we got it back today, and here we are with all of you.
Exactly.
So my first question, Ekta, is what do you have to say about the predictability of life or unpredictability of life, and how old were you when this thunderbolt hit you hard? Please tell the audience what happened.
Yes, life is very, very unpredictable, and unpredictable in very intense way. Like it can be very positive experience can also be here, and very terrible experience can also be there. And if I will talk about my accident that happened 18 years ago in 2003, and it was really a life-threatening accident. I was in the car and suddenly an overloaded truck of vegetables came and it fell on our car. And here I want to mention that the car was stationary. It was not moving. It was in the parking. And still an old loaded truck came and fell on the car. And the things didn't stop here. And again, when crane tried to lift the truck up, the chain broke and truck again fell on the car. So the car was completely crushed. And I met with the spinal cord injury. I broke my neck at cervical level. That means the paralysis of lower limbs and partial paralysis of upper limbs. So it was very, very unpredictable. I was preparing for my pre-medical test and I was going for the coaching institute. It was very first day of my coaching. So I have never thought that accident would happen, and especially of such a severe disability will be there with me. So it was very unpredictable, but with the right rehab and with the parent support, I started moving ahead in my life. And it is very important, like there was no awareness about spinal cord injury. The way I was taken to the hospital, I constantly needed support on my neck, but no attention was paid to my injury. And it took a lot of damage, the existing injury also. And after that also, many doctors refused to operate over me. But the spinal cord injury is all about the right rehab. And I shifted to Indian Spinal Injury Center in Delhi, where I got treated. I was operated and I spent 9 months in the hospital. So there we come to know what is spinal cord injury. Before that, I haven't seen anyone in the wheelchair, or I was totally unaware what is spinal cord injury. So there we came to know that life is still possible on wheelchair, and the right rehab and the right guidance from the peer counselors gave us some clarity, like still life is possible on wheelchair.
Ekta, aap bhagwan mein vishwas rakhte hain?
Yes.
Through the lowest of the low moments of your life, what was actually the main factor that pulled you through?
When I was in the hospital, for some months I thought that there will be some improvement and in few days I will start walking. And I thought that the spinal cord injury would be something like fracture, jo ki shayad 3-4 mahine mein heal ho jayega ya 6 mahine mein heal ho jayega. So I focused completely on my physio and I was very hopeful that I will start walking one day. But slowly I realized that 1 year is passed, 1.5 year is passed. Still there is no improvement in my lower limbs. Some improvement was in my upper limbs, but there was no improvement in my lower limbs. So slowly I realized that this is my life and I have to accept it. And it was not something that it happened suddenly. One day I woke up and I was in the acceptance mode. But it was like I started focusing on the things that I could do instead of focusing what is lost. Theek hai, I couldn't walk. But jitna main kar sakti hun, usme studies has played a very important role. And it is all the unconditional support of my parents that they always believed in me and they always encouraged me to move ahead. Even I was not sure would I be able to study or not because I couldn't sit by myself, I couldn't eat by myself. So there is a lot of assistance required in carrying out day-to-day activities. So life was very challenging, but with the right attitude of focusing on the things that are in our control, that are still can be improved in the existing situation. And with my parents' support, I started focusing on my education, and really it has opened it was the only ray of hope in my life at that time. And I realized that still there is something that I can do before I used to do. Haan, thoda sa career shift ho gaya, but I started enjoying my new subjects also. And above all, it has given me the self-confidence ki haan, abhi bhi I'm capable of doing things. Kyunki लोगों ने जो एक धारणा बना दी थी या इवन इट वॉज समथिंग अ वेरी न्यू एकता फॉर मी की कम्प्लीटली व्हील चेयर यूजर नीडिंग असिस्टेंस इन कैरिंग आउट डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज. सो मुझे भी लगने लगा वुड आई बी एबल टू डू एनीथिंग इन माई लाइफ. तो आई वॉज ऑल्सो इन डाउट, बट स्टडीज हैड ओपन अ लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर मी. एंड मेरे पेरेंट्स को तो मुझसे ज्यादा हमेशा ही confidence tha ki surely you can do, you can really achieve the things still you want to achieve.
Yeah, that's what my next question was, and you've already answered it. I just wanted to ask you whether this was initially, were you able to sense that you would be able to combat this tough situation that you found yourself in all of a sudden? You must have had some mental health issues as well. So actually, what was it? Who was the person that actually helped you to get reconciled to the situation and come to the realization that life is still full of worth?
Yes, it was mentally very, very difficult to accept a new wheelchair user life. And before that, I was totally unaware ki how my body will react after this injury. And how will I continue with my life with this wheelchair? But it is my parents' support, I would say. Even they were unaware ki exactly what has happened to their daughter, who is just 18 years old. But with the right rehab, where we connected to physiotherapists, occupational therapists, peer counselors, they let us know that life is still possible. And I saw many people there in the hospital who were excelling in their lives. The director of that hospital, who himself is Major HPSO Aluwalia, himself is quadriplegic, and he has established the whole hospital for the spinal cord injured persons. So we came to know that there are many great persons who are doing excel in their lives, in the front of career, in the front of social service. They are doing a great job. So still we can think about our dreams. Still our life is not restricted to this wheelchair. Being a wheelchair user, still things can be done, and especially the dreams can be achieved.
Wahi main kehna chahungi ki life mein aisa bahut baar hota hai, kuch aisi akasmik ghatnaen ghat jati hain jo humne bilkul bhi socha nahi hota. Isiliye hum bolte hain ki life unpredictable hai, and this is so bloody highly unpredictable. And at times you realize, jaise ki अगर आप कोई गेम खेल रहे हैं और अगर आपने गेम में आपके साथ कुछ जो आपने सोचा वो नहीं हुआ, तो आप सामने वाले को ये बोल सकते हैं कि दिस इज चीटिंग, आई वोंट प्ले, बट दिस इज लाइफ एंड यू हैव टू गो ऑन मीन्स प्लेइंग, एंड यू कांट रियली से टू गॉड कि ये चीटिंग है, ये सीन बैक जाना चाहिए, मैं इसके साथ रिकनसाइल नहीं कर सकती. सो दैट कम्स एक्चुअली एज अ थंडरबोल्ट फ्रॉम द ब्लू दैट यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट. दैट एक्सेप्टेंस इज द हार्डेस्ट पार्ट आई गेस.
Yes, ma'am. And moreover, this spinal cord injury is not only about that my legs are not moving. It is all about many internal organ systems are impacted. It is an injury to the central nervous system. आप मुझे देखेंगे तो एक आप कहेंगे कि एकता cannot walk. But it is not the only thing that I cannot do. There are plenty of other things in my organ systems within my body that are having complications and that I have to manage with the right schedule and everything. And at that time, it was so financially demanding. My family had to take a lot of financial burden because of that treatment. I spent 9 months in the biggest hospital in India. And it was physically, obviously, challenging, mentally challenging. And socially also, people have this outlook that what she will be doing in her future. And now she will be a burden and her dreams she won't be able to achieve. एक वो socially भी बहुत ज़्यादा discouraging था. मुझे याद है कि जब हमने college में admission लिया, तो there were many people who were saying to my parents, what is the hurry? मतलब let her improve herself. कि जैसे after an year I enrolled myself in the college, तो उन्होंने कहा कि भाई what is the hurry? क्या मतलब पढ़ा भी लोगे तो what will she'll do? हाँ, she won't get a job. Even if she get a job, so how she will do? So things were very, very demotivating. And
True.
But my parents were sure about this, ki I'm surely going to study. तो लोगों को लगता था कि पढ़ लेगी तो क्या हो जाएगा, जॉब तो नहीं मिलेगी, मिल जाएगी तो कैसे करेगी. सो थिंग्स वर वेरी अनक्लियर टू माई सेल्फ ऑल्सो, और फिर जो लोगों का और समाज की एक जो धारणा थी डिसेबिलिटी को लेके, और वो भी एक ऐसी थी कि जो सच में ऐसे करने होने लगा था कि यस लाइफ इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट नाउ. But it may be difficult, but it was not
not
impossible.
impossible. Yeah,
yeah,
it's not impossible. ऐसा होता है जब हमें समाज का एक कुरूप चेहरा दिखाई देता है, क्योंकि जहां पे हमें जरूरत है एम्पैथी की, या तो हमें वहां सिंपैथी मिलती है और या फिर पिटी मिलती है. एंड दिस इज समथिंग विच वी डोंट रियली लाइक, बीइंग ऑलरेडी अ विक्टिम टू द सिचुएशन, the adverse situation. And at that time when people come and try to express their pity over you and they are suspicious whether you would be able to manage your life further or not, so that suspicion mode of theirs really is very disheartening, right? So that's why I began by congratulating your parents, because it's their role, it's their courage that made you stand where you are.
और मतलब there were so many things said to me, तो I मतलब ऐसा नहीं है था कि there was more than those things said to my parents also, but they never let me, they never let those things to come to me. They try to keep me in that positive frame of mind.
Yeah, they kept you immune to. That's wonderful. So this phase of denial of the situation transcended soon into acceptance, and just because of the moral support that you had from your family, it really could happen.
Right.
So, how did the shift of the career happen? Because you actually wanted to become a doctor, and how did sports come in the picture?
पहले तो मैम, I will like to talk about the studies, the academics. I opted for English honors and psychology. Psychology isliye liya tha ki it was the only subject that was closest to sciences. So psychology isliye liya, and English honors mujhe English mein interest shuru se raha tha. So few people were there and that they guided me, that counseled me that English honors would be the right thing for you. And psychology mein mujhe interest tha. I thought ki it is something like sciences, biology जो मैंने पढ़ी, तो फिर मैंने ये सब्जेक्ट्स ऐसे चूज किए. और हिस्ट्री भी लिया, हिस्ट्री मैंने ऐसे लिया कि कुछ एक सब्जेक्ट और लेना था तो बस वो मैंने ऐसे पिक कर लिया. आई डोंट नो हाउ डिड आई चूज दैट एट दैट टाइम. तो इन द फर्स्ट ईयर ऑफ माय कॉलेज आई टॉप माय साइकोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट एंड आफ्टर दैट
वंडरफुल
देयर वाज नथिंग बैक. फिर मुझे सब्जेक्ट्स में बहुत इंटरेस्ट भी आने लगा था और एंड रियली साइकोलॉजी इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड टीचर्स हैव आल्सो स्टार्टेड सेइंग दैट दिस गर्ल इज गोइंग टू मेक वंडर्स. मुझे अब भी याद है एक हमारे इंग्लिश के प्रोफेसर थे, उन्होंने कुछ क्वेश्चन पूछा और आई आई रिप्लाइड ओनली आई कुड रिप्लाई दैट क्वेश्चन. तो उन्होंने कहा व्हेन इन दिस स्टेट इन दिस फिजिकल स्टेट व्हेन शी इज विजिटिंग द डॉक्टर्स एंड शी इज डूइंग फिजियोथेरेपी एवरी डे. फर्स्ट ईयर की ही बात है ये. तो इमेजिन शी इज गोइंग टू मेक वंडर्स. तो टीचर्स को भी इतना फेथ लगने लगा कि यस दिस गर्ल कैन रियली डू गुड थिंग्स. और फिर पेरेंट्स का सपोर्ट था तो मुझे भी खुद के अंदर कॉन्फिडेंस आने लगा. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आई गॉट न्यू फ्रेंड्स. आई स्टार्टेड गोइंग आउट ऑफ माई होम. इस इंजरी में सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट यही होता है कि व्हेन पीपल मीट विद एक्सीडेंट ड्यू टू असिस्टेंस रिक्वायर्ड एंड ड्यू टू द सोशल परसेप्शन पीपल डोंट मूव आउट ऑफ देयर होम्स. बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है. एंड वी वर टोल्ड इन द रिहैब टाइम लाइक इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट आफ्टर द इंजरी टू स्टेप आउट ऑफ द होम्स. और अभी भी मैं देखती हूँ कि इट इज द बिगेस्ट थिंग लाइक पीपल आर सो हेजिटेंट. डिसेबल्ड पीपल आर सो हेजिटेंट टू मूव आउट ऑफ देयर होम्स ड्यू टू द वेरियस रीजंस. फर्स्टली दे डोंट हैव मच अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू गो आउट. सेकेंडली दे माइट नॉट बी हैविंग मच सपोर्ट सिस्टम. बट थर्डली ऑल्सो द सोशल परसेप्शन इज लाइक डिसेबल पीपल आर नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड टू बी सीन एट मॉल्स और थिएटर्स और पार्क्स. सो देर इज अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ एटीट्यूड टुवर्ड डिसेबिलिटी. सो कॉलेज जाने पर मुझे बहुत सी चीजें मिली. एक राइट एनवायरमेंट मिला. आई स्टार्टेड फीलिंग सेम जैसे मैं स्कूल जाती थी वैसे आई स्टार्टेड गोइंग टू कॉलेज. आई गॉट टू
बिल्कुल
मेक न्यू फ्रेंड्स. टीचर्स वर देयर हु वर कॉन्स्टेंटली एनकरेजिंग मी एंड सपोर्टिंग मी. So there was complete change in my life of a wheelchair user. Yes, जब जाती थी तो people keep kept on staring कि oh she's on wheelchair and she's like requires assistance in moving out of the of her home. But लेकिन फिर वो चीजें धीरे-धीरे acceptance mode में आने लगी. Sports happened very later. It started in 2016 only after the 13, 14 years of my injury. तो वो भी एक बड़ा एक अनप्रिडिक्टेबिलिटी की बात जैसे हम कर रहे थे स्टार्टिंग में. तो अनप्रिडिक्टेबल तो स्पोर्ट्स भी मेरा उतना ही अनप्रिडिक्टेबल है. आई वाज नेवर इनटू स्पोर्ट्स. आई हैड नो क्लू हाउ टू गेट इनटू द पैरा स्पोर्ट्स. एंड इवन आई वाज सो बिजी इन माय जॉब एंड स्टडीज तो आई वाज नॉट फोकस्ड. आई वाज नॉट फोकस्ड इन दैट डायरेक्शन. बट वन ऑफ माय इंटरव्यूज वाज पब्लिश्ड व्हेन आई क्वालिफाइड माय हरियाणा सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जाम. And it was circulated on social media. At that time, my coach, my current coach, Mr. Amit Saroha, he contacted me. And when he came, he himself is a para sports person with the same disability, then he contacted me and asked me if I would like to do the para sports. तो फिर मुझे लगा बहुत पढ़ाई हो ली है और अब मुझे कुछ और भी करना चाहिए. और तो फिर मैंने स्टार्ट किया. फिर मुझे उसमें भी लग रहा था कि हाउ वुड आई be able. I am having job. Disability has also its limitations. I cannot sit for long hours. Like, so I need to maintain the things, manage the things. But you never know your potential until and unless you are in that situation.
Yeah, that's
Yeah,
beautiful.
your potential is even you are unknown to your potential, your true potential,
True,
and.
true. You keep exploring yourself every day.
Exactly. And after getting into sports, I realized that we can push our mental and physical boundaries. It is never fixed. It is never constant. We can always push them. We can always come out of the comfort zone. And when we come out of that comfort zone, then the miracles start happening. And I didn't know that I would be able to do the sports and the job. But slowly I mastered this act and my department has also supported me and when I won my first international medal in 2016. So it was like, yes, I can do this at bigger
stages. That was actually no less than a miracle in itself.
Exactly, exactly. I would say, jaise hi accident, it was so unpredictable. After that, my journey of hope started. I was hopeful that I would be able to do something. Yeah, I should try. But this sports journey is a story of miracle. It was totally unplanned, and it was, and it has been so beautiful also.
I agree. I totally agree with that. When we keep our eyes lowered in shame or self-pity, it's only when we give a right to other people to exercise their pity on us. It's when we keep our head high and move ahead with all our dreams despite all odds possible in our life, and then do the miracles happen, right?
Exactly, exactly.
And what do you think, what in your opinion is the thing that empowers a person in the means most adverse circumstances of life? And especially if we talk about a woman, what is it that empowers her the most?
There is always something within us that if we focus and if we work on it, we can always make our lives better. No matter how hard the situation is, we can surely improve our situation. True. My favorite quote is, life is not in our hands, but living is. No matter what life offers you, but still you have an option that where you want to move. You want True. Into the phase of negativity, or you want to get into the phase of progress. But always mind it, always have this faith that you are having those resources within you that you can make your lives better. So the day I started focusing on the things that are in my control, instead of focusing or cribbing or crying about the things that were lost, that started making difference. So like in everybody's life, there might be some challenges and unpredictable things would take place. But surely with our right approach, right mindset, we can move ahead. And yeah. There's one mantra that never give up. Nothing can stop you. There is always the doubts and the fears inside us that stop us. External factors can stop you for a moment, for a day, for a week or a month. But that permanent stoppage is only because of your barriers inside you. So
yeah, the real fight happens within.
Yeah, if you win the battle from inside, if you are sure about yourself, your decisions, your goals, nothing can stop you. No external circumstances. They can challenge you, but they cannot stop you. Your hard work and your right approach of mind, of positivity, can make your life better. It can help you in overcoming any challenge. Just don't give up if you are not happy True. With some situation.
There is a very beautiful comment I can see on the screen, and this is by Sonu Chaudhary. कि दुख का बक्सा साहस से हल्का हो जाता है, जिंदगी से शिकायतें कम हो जाती हैं, असीमित है आपका साहस एकता, आप बहुत सारे लोगों के लिए मिसाल बनेंगी, आपके पास ये वो जादू है जो हमेशा बरकरार रहेगा, और मेरी अशेष शुभकामनाएं, एंड प्लीज थैंकिंग मी टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू टू देम. Even I would like to extend a word to the people who have been fighting certain battles inside, that it's all about the attitude, how you see things. At times you do feel drained, you feel completely exhausted, and you feel like you can't move a step further. But once you have that hope rekindled inside, and you do believe that a good thing happened with the right kind of attitude, then nothing is impossible. कुछ भी असंभव नहीं. बिल्कुल
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
एकता, मैं आपसे जानना चाहूंगी कि आपकी जिंदगी का सबसे खूबसूरत लम्हा कौन सा था?
दो बता
नहीं, पहले एक ही बताइए. लेट्स गो वन बाय वन.
डेट वाइज ही बताऊंगी. Firstly, it was in 2013 when I qualified my civil services exam. It was a very great moment for me, because before that, people used to see me like she is not capable of doing the great things. With due respect, all professions, but उन्हें लगता था कि नहीं सिविल सर्विसेज शी इज नॉट मेंट फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज दे यूज टू हैव ठीक है शी कैन बी इन टू एनी काइंड ऑफ जॉब वेयर विच इज नॉट दैट मच डिमांडिंग बट क्वालिफाइंग दैट एग्जाम हैज रियली चेंज माई लाइफ पीपल वर नॉट एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट गर्ल विद सच सीवियरली डिसेबिलिटी ऑन व्हील चेयर वुड बी एबल टू क्वालिफाई दिस एग्जाम So that exam was a completely life-changing moment for me. I could see people were surprised. I could see in their eyes that they are surprised and they have changed their perception towards me and my disability. Otherwise, they were judging me on my disability. Now they are respecting me of my hard work. So that True. Was a completely changing moment. And here I want to say, you must not be judged by your circumstances. Yeah. You should be judged by your hard work. वैसे तो judgment is not a thing to
follow. Why should one be judged at all? Because none of us is the superior or on a superior pedestal to be able to judge other people. We should try to escape this kind of a tendency. We shouldn't be judging anybody.
But it is in our mindset, like society does judge you or comments on you so that should not be on the basis of your circumstances no matter what are your circumstances but that is not your identity your hard work your achievements is your identity so let not the circumstance overcome you you need to overcome those circumstances
true
and second moment would be my medal at Asian Para Games that was the gold medal at Asian Para Games That was a very, very big moment for me. And representing your country at international platforms, wo apne aap mein, it is such a matter of pride. And for winning True. Medals, so it is about your country. You are representing your country. You are winning medals for your country. It is the thing that everyone wishes. Everyone desires to get represent, to be represented. By their country, तो उसमें बहुत ही एक गर्व की स्थिति, एक गर्व की फीलिंग बहुत ज़्यादा रहती है कि yes and you are representing your nation, you are winning medals for your nation, so that is a greatest feeling.
So there has been one and two. Now I would like to ask about the third great moment of your life when Narendra Modi ji mentioned you. Did you actually know that this was something which was going to happen? Or it happened by chance, or you came to know about it by chance.
It is also having a very interesting story. I was doing my exercise, and I was at home. Suddenly, I got call from my uncle, okay. And he was shivering. एकता मुझे मगर क्या हुआ चाचा जी क्या हुआ तो एकता तेरा मन की बात में मोदी जी ने नाम लिया मैंने कहा है and he was so excited, so happy and Later, I came to know his hands were really shaking while calling me. So after that, there was plenty of calls, 20 to 25 calls I received that they heard my story of Mann Ki Baat. I was not aware of it. I didn't hear it. After the Mann Ki Baat, I received the recordings from many people. But at that time, I was unaware that my story would be shared. True. Usse kuch din pehle, I received an appreciation letter from Prime Minister, sir, about my medal at India. So I replied to him and I wrote that it is the greatest moment to hold the tricolor. It is the biggest moment for an athlete. I am happy and I am proud that I have done that. And he shared the same thing in the Mann Ki Baat. So it was a very pleasant surprise and my phone kept on ringing for long duration on that day. So it was
And your heart kept ringing too. Your heart kept ringing.
But I was so... surprised that my uncle called me and he was really out of the world. उन्हें लग रहा था वो एक तक हिस्ट्री मन की बात शेयर हुई है तो वो भी कुछ अपना गार्डनिंग का काम कर रहे थे तो वो भी एकदम से गए कि एक सच में एकता का नाम लिया वो फिर और थोड़ा नजदीक गए रेडियो के पास when he narrated the whole story then he was sure that yes it is the same एकता
आर एकता okay बिल्कुल बिल्कुल that's amazing तो जब सोशल मीडिया पे एक बार आपका नाम आया और जब नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने आपको मेंशन किया, उसके बाद का सफर कुछ खास रहा?
हाँ, खास रहा. पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड रिकॉग्नाइजिंग मी, एंड व्हेन आई मेट मिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी जी, आर प्राइम मिनिस्टर सर, एंड ही रिकॉग्नाइज्ड मी व्हाइल मीटिंग. आल्सो वी वर मेनी प्लेयर्स, व्हाइल आफ्टर द एशियन पैरा गेम्स वी वेंट टू मेट हिम एंड ही रिकॉग्नाइज्ड मी. सो दैट वाज द बेस्ट पार्ट, अमंग सो मेनी प्लेयर्स ही रिकॉग्नाइज्ड मी. So, and people were also starting. Yes, do you know her story shared in Mann Ki Baat, in office, at in the neighborhood, and that video was uploaded to me. Many people sent me that same video again and again. So it was very nice.
Truly amazing. Yeah, it was truly amazing.
Okay.
Ekta, moving on to a lighter note, I would like to know, who has been your greatest crush ever? Has there been one?
Yeah. John Ibrahim.
Fabulous.
Yeah. Since childhood, I wanted to meet him, and I'm really blessed to that I could meet him. And it was not only for 5 minutes or 10 minutes. I had a coffee with him, and we talked for around 30 to 40 minutes. And it was a great meeting. And वो बहुत ही अच्छा लम्हा था. एंड उसका भी यही था कि एक दो दिन पहले तक आई वाज नॉट श्योर वुड आई बी एबल टू मीट हिम और नॉट. ही वाज नॉट इन द ही वाज नॉट इन मुंबई, बट फाइनली थिंग्स मटेरियलाइज्ड एंड आई कुड मीट हिम. एंड व्हेन आई मेट हिम, ओ वेलकम एकता, वेलकम एकता. सो जॉन इब्राहिम वाज सेइंग दिस टू वेलकम एकता, सो दैट वाज रियली अमेजिंग.
सो व्हेन आई आस्क यू हु हैज बीन योर ग्रेटेस्ट क्रश एवर एंड यू नेम जॉन इब्राहिम, नो अदर देन जॉन इब्राहिम, then again you seem to have hatched your wagon to the stars. And what were those moments, those beautiful moments, I would like you to share with the audience, that you shared with me on phone, when you had so many butterflies fluttering in your tummy and you were moving to his place? What had actually happened? Why were you so restless? Was it because you wanted to go to meet him, or there was something else?
Yeah, there was something else also. I was stuck in the traffic jam.
So let the cat be out of the bag.
We were having an appointment around 1:30, and I was stuck in the traffic jam, and the appointment was only for like 40-45 minutes. Mujhe laga ki agar main itna time yahin pe lag jayega to pata nahi milungi bhi ya nahi milungi. So that was very कंफ्यूजिंग भी था, बहुत वो था कि कहीं मिल, मतलब इतनी प्लानिंग्स के बाद भी अगर ये अपॉर्चुनिटी मिस हो जाए तो. जस्ट तो पर फॉर्चुनेटली हम पहुंच गए, और ही वाज वेटिंग फॉर अस एंड ही वाज वेरी हैप्पी टू मीट अस. और 2 दिन बाद उनका बर्थडे था, तो मैं उनके लिए केक लेकर गई थी. We cut the cake and we exchanged few gifts. So he was very.
What were the gifts that you gave him?
I gave him Indian T-shirt with a toy motorbike.
Okay.
Fan of motorbikes.
That's fabulous. तो एक बार बहुत सारे फिल्मी सितारों से मिल चुकी हैं आपकी, काफी सारे पिक्चर्स मैंने शेयर की हमारे पोस्ट को प्रमोट करते हुए. So that people could actually have their interests, and they might be intrigued that they were going to meet a very interesting character, and they never need to pity her. She has to be held high in pride, and they should be feeling proud of you the way I do as an elder sister. I do feel proud of you. And इतने सारे फिल्मी स्टार्स से आप मिल चुकी हैं, do you consider them as stars, or do they consider you, or they consider you as a star?
They all have been so respectable. Matlab unhone itna respect diya every time we met. Either it was Shahrukh Khan ji ne bahut achhi baat kahi thi ki you are not lucky ki aapko medal milega, that medal is lucky jise aap miloge.
Wow.
To unhone to itna motivate tha bahut zyada ki that medal will be very lucky jinhe aap miloge. तो सभी ने बहुत ही मोटिवेट किया एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट वाज दैट दे वर वेरी एंथुसियास्टिक टुवर्ड्स पैरा स्पोर्ट्स कि ऐसा नहीं था कि भाई पैरा स्पोर्ट्स को लेके उनका कुछ एनकरेजमेंट कम था दे वर वेरी एनकरेजिंग टुवर्ड्स द पैरा स्पोर्ट्स इट वाज नथिंग अबाउट दैट इट कैन बी साइडलाइन इट शुड बी द पार्ट ऑफ द मेनस्ट्रीम द
ट्रू
प्लेयर्स शुड बी ट्रीटेड एट पार सो दे वर वेरी एंथुसियास्टिक अबाउट पैरा स्पोर्ट्स एवरी पर्सन फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री वर इक्वली encouraging and enthusiastic towards para sports.
Nice. And Ekta, आपने बताया कि जब आप banking के लिए exam देने गई थी तब you saw many candidates who had been on wheelchair and who were incapable one way or the other. So what was the realization that you reached to that day?
रियलाइजेशन ये है मैम कि वी आर हैविंग अराउंड 5 to 6 crores ऑफ पॉपुलेशन हु आर डिसेबल्ड एंड ओनली 1 out of 10 आर हैविंग द असिस्टिव डिवाइस. असिस्टिव डिवाइस होता है कि व्हील चेयर, आर्टिफिशियल लिम, एनी हियरिंग एड, क्रचेस, किसी भी तरह का असिस्टिव डिवाइस दैट कैन मेक योर लाइफ बेटर, इंडिपेंडेंट एंड improve the quality of your life. तो हमारे देश में अभी भी 10 में से जो नीडी लोग हैं उनमें से सिर्फ एक के पास राइट असिस्टिव डिवाइस है. If everyone is provided with the right assistive device, they can also live a fulfilling life. They can move around independently or with little assistance. They can get into the schools, colleges or any kind of workplace. But due to the unavailability of the right assistive device, they are restricted at their homes. They are not getting that opportunity to chase their dreams. Agar shuruaat to yahi se hogi, agar unke paas ek right device hoga, to they can go outside. And it is very important for disabled person to be the part of the mainstream. Inclusion bahut zaruri hai. And diversity hai, existence hai, but विजिबिलिटी नहीं है. तो इट डजंट मीन कि अगर आप डिसेबल लोगों को पब्लिक प्लेसेस पे नहीं देखते हैं तो दे डोंट एग्जिस्ट. दे डू एग्जिस्ट बट देयर विजिबिलिटी कम होने की वजह से पीपल डोंट हैव एनी आइडिया दैट हाउ बिग द नंबर इज ऑफ द डिसेबल पर्संस बट दे आर रिस्ट्रिक्टेड एट देयर होम्स. आफ्टर असिस्टिव डिवाइसेस वी कैन कम टू द पॉइंट ऑफ एजुकेशन. कैन यू बिलीव इट स्टिल देयर इज जस्ट 45% ऑफ लिटरेसी रेट of the disabled persons and only 20 to 25% are into regular job. So the situation of the disabled persons is still we need to make a lot of efforts. True. And even we are in the 21st century, there are many schools who deny admissions to disabled students, and that is not acceptable. Though we are having the law that no one should be denied for education, but they are denied. So, अगर आप एजुकेशन भी नहीं कंप्लीट कर पाओगे तो आपको जॉब कैसे मिलेगा. तो वी नीड टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स फ्रॉम असिस्टिव डिवाइस टू प्रोवाइडिंग इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन टर्म्स ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑल्सो. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एवरीवन टू बी. हर कोई इंडिपेंडेंट बनना चाहता है, फाइनेंशियली सेल्फ रिलायंट बनना चाहता है, एंड दैट इज द सेम केस फॉर डिसेबल्ड पर्सन्स ऑल्सो. सो वी नीड टू गेट we need to provide them, we need to implement the laws completely in letter and spirit that every person should get the equal opportunity to get educated. Then
I just wanted to ask you the same question. What made you realize that first of all the people with special needs do not have sufficient assisting devices, and what actually lies at the bottom? What is the root cause? That is it the government policy is falling short, or is it the execution that is falling short, or it's some social stigma attached to the people who are suffering from any kind of disability?
I would say it is all about the mindset. You will be surprised to know still there are families in our country, in our society, who don't disclose that they are having some disabled person in their family, a person with disabilities in their family. When survey collection ke liye log jaate hain, to they ask if there is there any person with disability at home. So they don't disclose it, the stigma is associated with it. So we don't have the right number firstly.
That's it.
I know many people ki unhe lagta hai ki agar unke family member mein unki family mein koi disabled person hai to they should not let others know about it. To wo us cheez ko openly discuss hi nahi karte hain. And it is
क्या
not about the
लड़कियों के मामले में और ज्यादा लागू होती है?
It depends, ma'am. Like if the disability में भी जो severely disabled persons हैं, they are lagging a lot. They are lagging behind a lot. जिनको severe disability है. Severe disability से मेरा मतलब है कि multiple disability. That can be in terms of intellectual disability and physical disability दोनों. Physical disability वालों को in comparison of visual or hearing impaired से जो severely disabled है, मान लो upper limbs or lower limbs both are paralyzed या it is something like cerebral palsy जो deteriorate भी हो रही है, तो severely disabled persons है, चाहे वो girl है चाहे वो boy है, उसमें I think stigma is same for them. But yes, थोड़ा सा हमारी सोसाइटी में गर्ल्स को लेकर है जो मुझे समझ नहीं आता, एक पर्सन इज डिसेबल्ड वो डिसेबल्ड है, हाउ द जेंडर मेक्स अ डिफरेंस कि इफ योर शी इज अ गर्ल और अ बॉय. सो फर्स्टली वी नीड टू चेंज दैट माइंडसेट. लॉ इंप्लीमेंट हो जाएगा, अपॉर्चुनिटीज मिल जाएंगी, बट अबाउट द माइंडसेट, इफ दे डोंट अलाउ देयर चिल्ड्रन टू कम आउट, दे डोंट लेट द पीपल नो अबाउट देयर चिल्ड्रन हु इज डिसेबल्ड, एंड इट इज ऑल अबाउट द माइंडसेट आई थिंक.
True.
अगर वो माइंडसेट से सपोर्ट करें, राइट माइंडसेट से एनकरेज करें, तो देयर आर नंबर ऑफ पॉलिसीज एंड लॉज आर देयर दैट कैन बी गेट अ पर्सन कैन गेट
इन द राइट डायरेक्शन.
या सो इट इज अबाउट द माइंडसेट, हमें एनकरेज करना होगा फैमिलीज को भी उस चीज के लिए, बहुत हमें एक मोटिवेट करना होगा कि दे डोंट दे शुड नॉट थिंक दैट देयर चाइल्ड इज नॉट कैपेबल ऑफ डूइंग एनीथिंग. If you will support them, encourage them, so they can also do the marvelous things like any other child in their
home. Like Ekta has done.
My parents supported, ma'am. I'm very, very blessed. Like they have always believed in me.
You come from a joint family, Ekta. Tell us something about your family.
Sorry, ma'am?
Tell us something about your family.
या मेरा सपोर्ट
परिवार में, हाँ
मेरा सपोर्ट मेरे पेरेंट्स रहे और मेरे पेरेंट्स का सपोर्ट मेरी फैमिली रही है. मेरे ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, मेरे चाचा की फैमिली, हम साथ रहते हैं, और अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट मेरे मामा, मेरे बुआ, एवरीवन हैज सपोर्टेड माय पेरेंट्स सो मच. मेरे जैसे अगर पिलर्स ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ मेरे पेरेंट्स रहे हैं, तो मेरे पेरेंट्स की स्ट्रेंथ मेरी फैमिली रही है. Everyone in my family, always there for us whenever we need. चाहे वो किसी भी टर्म में वो असिस्टेंस चाहिए होती है. तो
I guess there was a lag. I couldn't hear you.
Sorry for the interruption, ma'am.
I couldn't hear you. Okay.
Hello, your mic, your voice is not audible, ma'am.
You are perfectly audible to me. Am I? Are you able to hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. So I couldn't hear you. I guess you were on call, as you told. So I was just asking. You told me that you have a wonderful family, and your parents have been your rock solid support that actually made you realize your true worth despite whatever happened in life, and they helped you find your feet. And it was the extended family that helped them to help you. This is such a beautiful supporting system. So I would like to say that if we have any kind of problem in our life, if we at times feel helpless enough and we need to ask for help, there should be no hesitation for us to ask for help to the family. Because family is something that comes first and it remains there till the very last. So we should never be scared of asking help. And once we get that help, we truly are able to emerge.
मेरे फादर का यही मानना है, वो कहते हैं कि इट इज अ सिंबल ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ टू आस्क फॉर हेल्प. इट इज नॉट नॉट अबाउट वीकनेस, इट इज अबाउट
इट्स नॉट अ वल्नरेबिलिटी, इट्स नॉट अ वीकनेस.
यस, एंड बेटर इफ यू एक्सप्रेस योरसेल्फ इन योर राइट इन द राइट सिचुएशन, नो मैटर व्हाट योर सिचुएशन इज, यू शुड बी एक्सप्रेसिव अबाउट इट, एंड श्योरली देयर विल बी पीपल अराउंड यू हु विल हेल्प यू इफ यू आर रेडी टू गेट द हेल्प.
And you should be in the right frame to grasp every opportunity that comes your way, rather than feeling dejected by what wrong has befallen you. It would be much better that you learn to go against the wave, and there are people who can force you to do that. And that's a positive kind of force that you get from your family.
Yes.
So again, I would like to pay salute to the parents, the grandparents, your sister, everybody in your family who stood by you as a great support. And I just wish that any child like you, like me, because anything bad can befall anybody of us. We can all have bad experiences in our life. We can have mental issues, we can have physical issues, we can have accidents, we can have failures in our life. So rather than hiding within yourself and fighting that battle inside, when it seems to be all dark and dreary, it would be much better that you ask for help, you talk to your family. Communication is the good key to everything. Yes. And once you get that help, you can actually come out of any of the darkest moments of your life.
Truly, truly, ma'am. If you express yourself, no matter how are you feeling, even if you are not okay, that is also okay. If you are not feeling okay, that is also okay. But you should be expressive. You should express your any discomfort or whatever you are going through. Surely your family will cooperate with you, assist with you, and we should be ready to get that help.
You have been writing poetry as well, you told me.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have something?
I do have, yeah.
Let's go on.
Yeah, just hold on. So I will share my poem about life. The gist of life lies in pleasure and pain. A moment can make you cry. Next fresh moment gives reasons to smile and a new try. It may throw piles of questions, but it also gives answers in many notions. If yearnings are there for which we long, it plays music of beautiful song. Dark storms can be beaten with gifts of spring that can be lightened. Hails and high waves in tumultuous way, surely a rainbow in every new day. Blend of blossoms and thorns can be in the way. See the blossoms, throw the thorns away. Delight is the present of acceptance. Every moment starts making sense. Happiness and learning are its spirit and soul. Journey of attaining them is its goal.
Beautiful. This was beautiful, and it does reflect the positive spirits that you are bubbling with. And that's what has brought you here. And that is what has brought me to introduce you to the people, and they have all been finding you as an inspiration. So thank you so much, Ekta, for coming to the show and being the source of inspiration, the foundation of positive energy to all the people who have been suffering from something or the other. And they do at times feel it's all dark. So there is a light, and hope is that light.
Exactly.
Thank you so much, Ekta, for coming here. And
welcome,
God bless
ma'am, you. And I'm so thankful to you too for inviting me here. आई डिडंट फील इट लाइक एन इंटरव्यू, मुझे तो जैसे लगा हम वैसे ही बात कर रहे हैं. तो
बिल्कुल,
इट वॉज रियली अ गुड एक्सपीरियंस.
थैंक यू सो मच,
वेलकम,
गुड इवनिंग.
गुड इवनिंग.